2:30, baby, won't you meet me by the pier? Too early, maybe later, you could show me things. You know what it is whenever I visit.
When you see
throwing me kisses, no. 30 degrees, way too cold, so hold me tight. Will I see you at the show tonight?
But now I'm gonna be doing the explaining part of this video, but actually let me get some water. Oh my gosh, my nose itches. It just spilled. It's like not even at the top, it's above the top. I kind of spilled it, if you didn't hear me say that, but it's okay, you know? It's okay. Okay, now on to the explaining part. Oh, I also want to show you guys something. If I can find it. Oh, found it. It was like hiding in plain sight. Okay. So this is my ticket that I got to the amusement park, which was kind of probably a spoiler. I should have waited till I got to that part of the story to tell you, but there we go. Really pretty, isn't it? Okay, so I didn't know that I was going to be doing my first ever YouTube video at all. Like, I've been wanting to have a YouTube channel for so many years now, and I've kind of been procrastinating and not doing it, but here we are. Finally did it. Now I just gotta edit and post. My first ever YouTube video will be done. But yeah, I didn't know that I was going to be doing my first ever YouTube channel, like I said. And so, I don't know, I was like, oh my gosh, I should do a haul because I'm going to be shopping at Mall of America. This is going to be so great. So then I was like, I'm going to do this. It was like mid-trip that I decided this. So I didn't, since it was mid-trip, I didn't vlog or anything because, well, I don't have a camera first off. So I have to use my mom's iPad. Well, I was planning to use my sister's iPad, but she's not here. So I was using my mom's iPad. And yeah, I couldn't vlog because of that. And also, I didn't know that I was gonna do it until I was already on the trip. I was already gone. So let's start from the beginning. Since I didn't vlog, I'm gonna kind of explain everything to you as if you were there with me. Okay, so first off, I went with my dad's friend and my dad and all of my dad's friend's family. And my dad's friend, they didn't tell her kids because it was supposed to be a surprise. But they did tell some other people because of like arrangement issues. And my dad told me, I wasn't supposed to know, but my dad told me. And so then I knew that we were going to the Mall of America. And so I was really excited. And I was like, oh my gosh, yay. This sounds so cool. I've heard of it before, but I didn't really know what it was. Like, it's pretty self-explanatory. It's a mall. It's in America. But I didn't really know what it was. And so, yeah. Actually, quick break on the story time. If you don't know what Mall of America is, it's the largest mall in America. And it has so many different shops. So many different restaurants, fast food places. There's literally a whole amusement park in there with roller coasters and different rides. And it's so amazing. I'm telling you, so amazing. You gotta go there if you haven't been. But I didn't even know all that stuff about it. Like, I was starting to hear it. I've heard of it before. But once I went, I was just like, wow. They had things to show you where to go, like little screens. And it was really fun. And it was pretty easy to get around. Some people were saying, well, pretty much everyone I think would say that it's really easy to get lost in there, but I wasn't getting lost. It was actually pretty easy to navigate and stuff, and it didn't look that hard to me, but I don't know. Back to story time. So I had found out, and I kind of got packed late, not gonna lie, but we're gonna try to stop doing that. And I did pack some pretty cool clothes, but I did think I overpacked, and I packed a swimming suit, but we didn't even have a hotel. I mean, the hotel we were in didn't even have a pool, and so I brought two swimsuits for nothing. So we were there one day, kind of only one day, like we were there 2 days, but we drove there on the first day, and we were there for the rest of that day, so that was like half a day. And then on the second day, we were there most of the day, and then at the night time we drove back. So it was kind of one day, 2 days. But yeah, and so the ride there, my dad's friend got this huge van, and like 15 seater. That's how huge. And that didn't even fit all the people. That's how many people went, and that's how huge the van was. And so I chose my seat. It was on the edge, like to the side. The ride was 6 hours, wasn't that long. And it was, I kind of slept most of the time, but I also listened to some music. I read a little bit. I kind of just sat there. But then after the trip, we stopped a few times, but not like two, maybe three. That's how many we stopped. And then we got there, and there was this really pretty and really fancy hotel. So I saw all the hotels, and I was like, oh my gosh, this looks really pretty on the outside of the hotels. And then I walked into our hotel, and I was like, it's very, very fancy. I was like, I love this hotel, but it's also very fancy. It looks really rich. And there were literally guys sitting at the tables, like really neat tables, with their iPads and all their paperwork, their computers, just working. And they were literally in suits. And I was just like, wow, this looks like a business hotel where sports people, sports managers come to work, and all those different managers and CEOs and stuff come to work. And I was like, oh my gosh, yeesh. But you know, I really liked the hotel. They were accommodating. We weren't really in there that long. One night is all. And then we spent literally an hour after that getting like checked in, because there were so many people. There were different room situations. We had like six different rooms. So I was kind of getting bored, obviously. And then we finally found our way up to the rooms, and I stayed with some older girls who were my dad's friends' nieces and daughter. And so they were like my age, but like the older ones in the teenager range had the room keys. And so then we walked in, and it was so beautiful. When I tell you, so beautiful. There were two beds, but they were really tiny, not gonna lie, but it was still really beautiful. And there was TV, and you could literally log into your streaming service. I logged into Netflix, made sure to log out though. And I watched a show, and it was really, really good, really fun. And then everyone was thinking, let's go do the rides. But then my dad was like, oh, it closed at 6, but like the rest of the mall closed at 9. And we were like, oh, that's so bad. But then we went there, and after a little while of like just walking around and stuff and like shopping, but we didn't actually shop, we were like, it's past 6 and the rides are still open. So I found out that the rides were still open, but we still didn't like go that night, because they have day passes, and it kind of would have been a waste, because we would have only been there for like 2 hours, 2.5. And so we kind of kept on shopping, but I was kind of the only one who actually shopped. But I didn't even actually get anything that day, but I did see what I wanted to get for the next day. So that's what I did. After that, I had Shake Shack. And I don't know if you guys have heard of Shake Shack. You probably have. But I've been hearing about it from people like all those big cities, LA and stuff, and all those different YouTubers saying how good Shake Shack is. And I was like, oh my gosh, I want to try it. I really, really want to try this. But there's not one in Omaha or Nebraska as far as I know. So I went there and I got fries, and I got a sprinkle shake, which was like, it's not one of the main shakes, it's like just seasonal, I guess. I think that's what they called it. And then I also got me from another store / restaurant, another food place. I got a cookie, a butterfly cookie. It was pink. And then, oh, I just forgot the word for it. It starts with a C, and it's like creamy, and it's like a roll, and I don't remember how to, I know I'm gonna remember, and I'm gonna be mad that I didn't remember, and I forgot. But I tried that for the first time, and so here's what I thought of everything. So the shake was disgusting. I did not like it. I wanted to spit it out, but I finished it because it cost a few bucks. And it wasn't my money, it was my dad's money, so I was like, I'm gonna finish this. And then the fries, as far as the fries, those were amazing. But I didn't get like a full course meal because we were supposed to eat afterwards. But as it turns out, the things that I did get filled me up. So yeah. And then I got that from Shake Shack, and that's what I thought about that. But as far as the dessert place, the cookie was good. At first it kind of tasted like clay. And no, I have not tried clay before. I don't know what clay tastes like, but it felt like it tasted like clay. So I didn't really like it, but it kind of grew on me. And actually, it was pretty sugary after I started having more bites. So I did like that after a little while. And then the other thing that I cannot remember the name of was really, really, really good. Like, it was really good. 10 out of 10. And then we went to this other place. So I was still with all those other kids. We were shopping and stuff, all teenagers. And so, then we went to meet the adults at the restaurant and also the little kids at the restaurant. And, it was, so we were supposed to go to this place called Rainforest Cafe, but didn't go because we needed to make like a reservation because it was really, really full. So we probably should have made a reservation. We don't need to make one, but we probably should have. It was really full. And so instead we went to this other place. I don't remember what it's called, but the food was really good. I got jambalaya, and like I said, I was kind of full from the other stuff, but I still ate some of that. And I didn't get to finish it because by the time we got back home, I hadn't ate it and it got old. Same with the food that we got the next night, but that's kind of spoilers, so let's stop saying that. But then after we ate, we went home. I took some pictures, which I will be putting up. It might even be the thumbnail for this video, but I'll show you guys. I haven't really seen them, but I think I'll like them. And so then after that, I literally went to the hotel and I knocked out right away. I got myself ready for bed and then I was gone. Well, I watched an episode, but then after the episode, I was gone. So that first day that we drove there and that whole day I just described was Friday, but I didn't know that. I totally forgot my whole days. My days got so messed up. I thought that Friday was Saturday. I thought the Saturday was Sunday. I thought the Sunday was Monday. So on the 4th of July, I thought that it was Tuesday, and I thought today it was going to be Wednesday. And so then everyone was telling me I was wrong. I was like, what are you guys talking about? You guys are wrong. These are the right dates. But apparently, I was kind of going cuckoo. So the next morning, I got breakfast, and it was really, really good. I got eggs with ham. I got a croissant. I had scone. I tried two different types of cheeses. I don't remember the name. One starts with B, one starts with the M. And I had heard of the one that starts with the B before, and I tried it, and I did not like it at all. It was disgusting. And the one that starts with M, I hadn't tried it before, but it kind of sounded fancy, as well as the other cheese. So I was like, let me try it. And that one was pretty good. It wasn't the best cheese I've had, but at the same time, it wasn't bad. And then I had some other stuff that I can't really remember. I had some orange juice, and that was all really, really good. But I kind of got full from it. And then at like 11, we went to the Mall of America, and me and my dad just went so that I could get some shopping done, and my dad could get some shopping done before like I went on rides and I was with the teenagers and everything, because everyone else was still like kind of in bed. So we got on the, we didn't get on the rides. We started shopping, and so that's when I started getting some of my stuff that I saw the day before. And so shopping kind of went fast for me because I already knew what I wanted. And then I went on the rides, I got my pass, it was a lot of money too, and it was for the whole day, and guess what, I went on my first ever roller coaster, yay, and it was really fun, and it was also really scary. It was like this teal ride, and it literally went up, and then a drop, and I was just like, oh my gosh, but it wasn't even that scary, and then it like flipped all around, it turned over, but it wasn't that big, and I don't think I'm ever gonna do a roller coaster that's that big. But I did my first ever roller coaster, and I'm 13, so that's kind of a late start for roller coasters, but I was kind of scared. I'm not scared of heights, but roller coasters, I've kind of always been afraid of getting on them and stuff, and I still am. I'm not ever gonna do a big one, I don't think. But as far as that, it was kind of scary, but at the same time, it really wasn't, and I did it a lot more times after that. And I also did some other rides. We literally had to wait an hour long for this one ride that was in the water, and it was really annoying. It was also a roller coaster, it had two drops, but it was really annoying. The line tricked us. We thought we were gonna have to wait less time. Sorry what I just did. But like, the light's not working on this. Like I said, that 1 hour long roller coaster waiting was very annoying. And so after that, I went and did some more shopping with my dad because there were some other roller coasters that they did that I was kind of scared to do because I may have done four different roller coasters, but wasn't ready for some of those other ones. There weren't even roller coasters, they were just like some other rides, and they were pretty scary. After that, before me and my dad even went and we got breakfast and stuff, we packed up our stuff at least, and we put it in the van, and then we went to the Mall of America. And so then at the end of the day, we'd already be ready because checkout time ends at 12, and we didn't even do the checkout. The person, my dad's friend, who like set it all up to the checkout. But yeah, we got all our stuff ready. And so then at the end of the day, we probably somewhere around, like I said, the mall closed at 9, but it's probably somewhere around like 10 we left, or maybe 10:30, 11. We left and we rode back. We didn't get back till like 5 in the morning. And it was just like, whoa. I literally, as soon as I got back home, I fell asleep. I was tired. And so then I woke back up again at like 3 p.m. And so then in all, I got like 15 hours of sleep or something. And it was like, oh my goodness. And then on the way back, they literally made like 5 stops. So every time I got up, it was so loud that I had woke up. And then I used the bathroom a few times. But sometimes I just like woke up when I went back to sleep. And it was just like, ugh. And then we got back home and that was the end of the trip. And yeah, overall, I'd probably give this experience 7 out of 10. You know, there were some really good things. I really liked the food. That was really good. Oh, I also forgot to mention, somewhere, I don't really remember when. Oh, kind of after we did the rides a little bit, we got food and I tried Panda Express, I think for this first time, but I don't know for sure. But I tried Panda Express and it was really good. But at the same time, it was really good actually. You know, it was good. Probably rated 9 out of 10, 9.5. But I couldn't finish that either because I forgot about that too. I ate a tiny bit on the ride back, but then like I fell asleep, so then it was just sitting out. So I'd throw that away too. But yeah, the trip overall, probably rated 7 out of 10. There were some really good parts. There's parts I didn't really like, but overall it was pretty good. The food was good, the rides were good, the shopping was good, but overall, pretty good experience. And I would definitely love to go to the Mall of America again. And I definitely advise that you do. And like I said before, this is my first ever video. So sorry if it's a little chaotic. Sorry if it's not the best video ever. And also sorry about this like lighting, one. I don't know. It's just annoying me. And then two, the how, I won't really call it blurry, but like how focused it is and stuff, because it's on an iPad. And it's like not an updated iPad, like it's kind of an older version of the iPad, but you know, I think it's fine. It's not the worst first video I've ever seen, definitely not the worst. But thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure to like, subscribe, go comment down below. Turn on your post notifications and subscribe to my new channel. It's going to be called Jasmine, I'm pretty sure. But yeah, I kind of, you know how Rihanna and Beyonce and all that stuff, I want to be a one name girl, you know? So I'm going to go with Jasmine, I'm pretty sure. But please go do all that stuff. Please watch the video. Please share it with your friends. It's my first ever video and I really want it to go up right away. So I'm hoping it does, fingers crossed. And thank you again so much for watching. I hope you guys had a great day. Bye. Thank you so much. And I'm gonna think of something to say at the end, because I know different people have some really good things they say at the end of their videos. So I'm gonna try and come up with one. But as far as like the whole video, thank you so much for watching. Love you guys so much. Bye. 2:30, baby, won't you meet me by the beam? Too early, maybe later you could show me things. You know what it is whenever I visit.